interpretation possible, and Bach especially, there's two main approaches. Many years ago, you know, I got a Baroque bow just to learn how it feels, get inspired. Fewer years ago, I did the switch. I still play with a modern bow, but I really prefer the Baroque bow. I'm sure you tried. Have you?
It's been a long time.
Okay. I recommend everyone Sharp Music, 100 bucks. Are going to be cheaper than a private lesson. And you never hear this again. And you get the feeling once in a while this is cheap for what it gives you. And informs you about a number of things. The first is that with this bow, it becomes especially absurd to sustain very long because you have to fight against the, you know, being much lighter. So, also the concept, and I will mention a few things, and then we go. You know, the concept, old school teachers used to tell us, down bow equals up bow. Our challenge, and we are going to make sure that those sound equal in strength at the beginning. With this bow, it becomes especially absurd. And from all what we read, it's not what we're looking really in terms of what they are used to be. Merge that with our possibility to, like, if you see stars and you decide to make a figure, you know, like constellations, our brain can, we don't, a lot of times we don't really need to sustain the note all the way in order for our brain to get it. Yeah? So, I don't want to speak too much, but when we start really or at the front, or consider options, vibrato diminuendo, yeah, or vibrato di accelerato. Thank you.
between the rest of the what we're looking is somewhere in between. Personally, I do love a lot to keep those leading tones and the two voices really independent. Will you try it once for fun? Or let's do something. I play the bass and I play the melody with leading tones, like it would be a melody.
Thank you.
historically a mint alternation, so a sweet alternation might have been the issue. Depends how much you want to see. Last thing about this movement, theory of affects, you know what that is? No? Anyone? No? Affects. In the Baroque, there was the big idea of one movement, one mood. For the most part in Bach, you know this, okay? So for the most part, these are dances where movements or arias or whatever, and so there's not too much need to do different feelings in the middle of the movement. Arguably, Bach is going somewhere else, arguably in the Chaconne we have different movements, arguably we need to change, but maybe not. In the middle of the movement you do something beautiful and you start going slower, but maybe it's just an effect that is, you know, not needed or not appropriate. You can think of it is beautiful, but you know, maybe it's not it's from something, another menu. So Allegro, really nice. Why don't you play? The problem with this bow now is that because of the humidity, it's completely flat and it should be like this. But if you know, downbow is not the same as up. So this is how they played 4 years ago. There's many examples of people that play incredibly good like that. But if you play with this, it becomes really absurd to do, you know, this sort of. Like exercise.
Thank you.
apples are easier, it's sort of more aerodynamic, it's easier to change strings, which goes with, you know, playing in low positions and not avoiding string changes. Should this be all one tempo? Is it a more perpetual?
Yeah.
Okay, so feel free to enjoy a few notes more here and there. It's doesn't need to be. Yes, why don't you go along from somewhere else?
Thank you.
your open up the elbow motion and you know correct without care of now. Can anyone? Is it me or whatever is doing like that? Look, I have the phone. It will, it's hurting. It won't hurt you because you. There we go. Now, pull. You know, like. No. That's okay. Let go. I want to feel like that's a string. Move my arm, please. With responsibility. Yeah, see? That is.
Yeah.
Yeah? We need that in order to play the violin. It's enough tension to be in front of 200 monkeys and, you know, doing a lot of monkey business there. It's very, very tough, so we have to feel completely free, otherwise it's impossible. There we go. No. Yeah. Just let all of these muscles completely from these ones. Yeah, let's do this. We'll try one more time, please. Very good. So now with that feeling. And
low price, two low slices on the inside of the string, so that there's not so much gap.
Thank you.
beautiful, beautiful place. Any questions? Complaints? No? Work on this, yeah?
Thank you. questions while we wait for the history.
Change of violence.
So this is a good practice because shit happens in concerts too. Beautiful play, and she had a lesson this week, I think, or last week. And I don't know, this, I have to believe that you are trying out. Still feels a little bit like, really like your sound. Still feels like you might not be your knees. Yeah? And I want to see again what happens when you and it's a little bit that you could also stay completely straight and just not knock them. Yeah? Knock them is when you push them back. Yeah? Generally speaking, musically, I'm also missing the long line. I wonder if you could play a little bit by memory and try to sing all the time ahead for your play. You know, well, a typical exercise that I'm not sure if you saw Guillaume master class where he asks to dig in very deep and then play a big phrase without breathing out or taking again air and going to try it. Because we as string players take for granted that we would have always again air, but if you would be a wind player or a singer, you would have the physical constraint and incentive to play longer phrases, yeah? And that influences the tempo that you take and the connection that you do. Would you please breathe very deep as much as you can and then hold the air and try to use that to create a long phrase. try to do.
it's a little bit a tango twister, but practice. Stop. Before I go,